1969, called For a Thousand Mothers, from a stand-up album. Before that, one of the really old ones from the first Jethro Tull album, called My Sunday Feeling. But out of the old songs, let's do you one of our new songs now. This is from 1976. It's a kind of folky thing. It's a nice little acoustic piece about a mythical English creature who lives in our green woodlands and keeps an eye on all the things that grow. Well, you know everything. Everything there is to know about Jack in the Green. With his long tail hanging down, he quietly sits under every tree in the folds of his velvet gown. He drinks from the empty acorn cup that you look on sweet to leave his nose. And times who came up on the ground signals the snow room, so it's time to grow. It's no fun being Jack in the Green. No place that time is no time for song. He wears a cutter's heart. Thank you. that slipping into the sexy, if constrictive, harness of that dream machine, the Hohner Piano Accordion, otherwise referred to as the instrument from hell, but that depends who's playing, I suppose. Andrew enjoys this more than any other spot in the whole evening. A hero of mine, and in fact an earlier hero of mine, is probably a hero of yours. His name was Mikhail Gorbachev, and if it wasn't for him, none of us might be standing here tonight. But then the man who came after him, Mr. Boris Yeltsin, also performed a very important function of keeping us free from nuclear war for all those years in the early 90s. He did this because he was so fucking out of it on the vodka. Poor old Boris could never find the button to press to send the missiles on the other. But, Mr. Putin is not a drinking man. He knows exactly where the button is. You better watch out for Mr. Putin. This will dedicate to Boris, though, because he's a good guy with three left feet, and this is not to dance if you're Boris dancing.
Thank you.
very much. Now back in 1972, I had the good fortune to have a little relationship with a 12-year-old boy. And I didn't go to prison either. I didn't get it was a different sort of relationship, a purely artistic one. A young boy by the name of Gerald Bostock wrote the lyrics to this piece. Gerald Bostock was 12 then, he'd be about 43 or something. About the same age as Michael Jackson, probably. This is a little section of a piece of music that he kindly wrote, and every twice a year, this little guy, the big guy, sends me the royalty check. Isn't that weird? What a kind person. What a nice person, too. This is a little touch of a thick as a brick. Wow.
Let's go. don't you make all your animals tails? And you wise men don't know how it feels to think as a
I'm
had your piece, so it's, even older than Jethro Tull. This goes all the way back 300 years to when J.S. Bach wrote this piece of music, way back when. I was still in short trousers back then. This one is, this would be turning into a piece of loathsome cocktail lounge jazz over the years. But to give it some cred, some credibility, we've enlisted the help of an assistant here, and his name is Ralph Hubner. And Ralph has a secret life. Yes, he has a secret life playing electric guitar in a fucking rock band. His real daytime job is the principal violinist of the Neue Philharmonie of Frankfurt. Yes. When he's not playing with that, as you can see. He's going to join us this piece a little later on as well, and another one is Bach's Bourrée with Ralph and Jonathan Watson.
Thank you.
one of my very favorite songs, actually two of my favorite songs, because when I do these two, as a special reward, I get 3 minutes off after this to go backstage and have a widdly wee. Yeah, you love to have a widdly wee, but you're stuck down there, you've got nowhere to go. Tough shit. Martin Barr is going to play one of his other instruments, as well as Andrew Giddings, and we've set up the bongos for them to join us towards the end of this first piece. Sax song to begin with, called Cheap Day Return from the Aqualung album, followed by the upbeat and fun but weird Mother Goose. Is it? Martin cut his finger on the cheese sandwich. Slight exaggeration, but more or less. But he's, yeah, is it okay? Okay. Sharp cheese. Thank you. It's about an empty cafe. There's quite a nice to sit in empty cafes and drink his Starbucks cafeteria. Alone. So you see Martin in a cafe, all by himself, all alone. Don't go near him. You'll get really pissed off. Empty cafe.
Thank you.
decided to lend it a touch of the Irish. Whatever that might be. It's got given a kind of Irish jiggy sort of feel, and it's a piece originally called If Jesus Saves, and then we change the name from the album to Hymn 43. How can we say what great name?
Yeah.
translation wasn't clear. If everybody would stay like him home,
international competition in the year.
She was incredibly pleased her part. Well, you can keep out what my heart had called. While she ran a perfect circle, and she wore a perfect smile. We had a cause of love, don't you know? Nervous and loose shivers down the wall. Yeah, but she didn't play such paper. In fact, she wasn't there at all.
Thank you.
stands to the king you hold, and know them, I dream of thee. Taking time, the only way he knows.
Thank you. Thank you. Moving.